I used to have a yoga teacher actually who was very vocal about the Bikram guy. He would preach in during yoga lessons.
Way.
No, he would be like, don't sell yourself out and don't do Bikram yoga, stay here.
I'd imagine he's very good at something. He must be gifted in some way to whatever. But then
yeah.
With that comes sort of darker side.
Also the power, I guess.
That's what I mean. You know,
that when you have so many people following you and listening to you.
It's a bit grotesque, but it's kind of abusive power.
Well, you must have that in the music industry as well. Have you ever encountered that?
The thing is, because I'm not a girl, I can't really speak on their behalf.
But you have female friends.
Well, yeah, I mean, another band, Cat Size, I think
yeah.
Rachel, singer, she said she never experienced sexism until she went into our side, because she was classical, and it's not so much like
yeah.
that. But when she went to our part of the music industry, she said it was really like extreme. You know, we'd go to meetings, they wouldn't even look at
So when you're more on the poppy side of things?
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, exactly.
When people have power over you, or when they know that you're dependent of them, this unhealthy dynamic, I don't know.
Yeah.
You're vulnerable as a woman, in
yeah.
general, I think, so, yeah.
But I think men have to do more.
Have you seen the music industry change in the past 10 years?
Yeah, a lot. I mean, yeah, in that it's very hard to be a new band now. And there's more bands than ever. But as a result, it's, you know, and there's more ways to reach people than ever. But then as a result, it's harder. So I think the Horrors were lucky in that we started just before it became really difficult.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're okay. But I think for bands that started just after us, I mean, there's not really many of them that stay past 6 years, maybe.
What do you think you can attribute that to, that you're still around?
Some of them weren't very good as well. I think I don't feel as if we've done really what we want to achieve. You know, I think there's new things that we keep reaching for, you know, with each record, and then there are new things that motivate us all. But I think it's difficult to keep a band together and going in the same direction.
Who's the most difficult person in the band?
I would say probably I'm the most difficult.
How does that manifest itself?
Well, I'm sort of like a child.
Okay. Well, I do think being a musician stunts your development.
Oh yeah, for sure,
sense.
Definitely. But then, you know, sometimes you allow it to be stunted. To be honest though, my favourite people that I've met, the people whose minds that I, you know, like respect or whatever, they are like children, and they don't, I think, you know, being when you stop being curious about things, then, you know.
Is there anything you wish you would have known starting out back then as a band that you know now and you wish somebody would have told you?
I don't really believe in giving other bands advice. I think it's kind of, I don't know, just if I was 20, I wouldn't want any advice from anyone.
No.
You know, and I imagine most of those people feel the same. But the only thing I think is that people are always trying to kind of, they see someone doing something unique, and then they think, okay, I want to be unique in that way, and they forget what's actually making them good.
Yeah.
You know, so it's kind of one of those like cliche lessons about being yourself.
Yeah, I know.
But it is important, because
yeah.
it's like you have to find what you're good at.
Yeah.
And play to your strengths.
Which I think, in my opinion, is something that's hard to find out when you're that young, when you're 20s. I think that comes at a later stage in life where you start
yeah.
really realizing who you are and what your capabilities are and what works for you.
I think you have to be quite stubborn.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's really important.
So, working on the new record, I think the opening track, Hologram, was originally a 25-minute long ambient house track.
Yeah, at its worst, yes.
Oh, at its worst, okay.
Well, no, at its most indulgent, because that would be the song. We kind of used that song to experiment on. And it, in the end, shaped the direction of the whole record.
Yeah.
So there was a point where maybe it wasn't quite as concise as it could have been.
I think it's really interesting to see that bands at a certain point now start using the studio as a sort of extra added instrument.
Yeah. I mean, it seems weird not to. But then again, I think it's really cool when a band has nothing and they make the most of it. You know?
Yeah.
I think playing with the means available to you, I mean, that's the whole reason I got into being in a band, because when I was at school, like, I was with all these guys who were like playing Eric Clapton covers, and like, you know, like they were playing the school concert, and everyone was like watching them going, wow, they're amazing, they can play, you know, and they were
yeah.
shit.
Was there a way during this record that you were forced to step out of your comfort zone?
I think we do that every time without really meaning to, because I think we change the conditions that we make each record in. And we've never sat down before a record and gone, okay, we want to go that way. But we've changed every time. You know, we've built a studio, or we've, you know, gone to work with Paul, whatever. And it does mean that the whole record changes. I think when things are too comfortable, it's just the absolute worst for creativity.
Yeah.
For me, and I don't like it. I want to be around things that are unfamiliar.
Yeah. No, he didn't bring out a saxophone at some point. You were like, no.
Hey, no, I love a saxophone.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah, totally. I mean, James Chance can torture
okay, right. Well, yeah.
Can't be that. And then, what's his name? Talk.
Yeah.
You've heard the, you know, so those records, yeah. Amazing. You know,
yeah.
It's like
yeah.
A texture is, yeah.
Do you still include this request in your writer? I know that you had a funny
surprise request
that doesn't surprise us. Is that still a thing?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, it's just not everyone goes for it, but... yeah, when they do, it's appreciated. I mean, we've had some amazing things. We had Brian Wilson's bicycle horn given
okay.
to us,
oh,
which
wow.
is amazing.
Yeah.
We had a girl in a box once.
Yeah, I think I read that.
Yeah,
you
just
you left her in the
yeah,
box.
We left her in the box.
That's horrible.
Well, we were giving her the surprise.
Okay, all right. returning the favor.
Yeah, exactly. It's only fair.
Do you listen to music on tour? Because I know that when you record a record, you try to...
Yeah, don't listen to music at all, yeah. And it's kind of weird because... You know, I'll realize that I haven't actually sat down and listened to a record for 6 months.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, it's quite, and it feels quite alien, but yeah, I mean, I've been producing a lot with other people.
The label that you do as well, right?
Yeah. But that's kind of just for fun. But I mean, I work with a band called Happy Meal Limited. I don't know if you've heard them. I produced their first single.
Okay.
And I think they're really good.
Okay.
I've been working on pop things, which I find really liberating. I work with a band called Let's Eat Grandma.
Okay.
These two girls from Norwich. They're only 17, but they're on their second record, and they're really good.
Are there any musical avenues or lyrically that you still feel like you want to explore? Because I know that you said that you adapted a more personal approach.
If you were to ask me directly what the song was about, I would just tell you.
Okay.
But then... If you say generally what they're about, I mean, they are, they've always been personal, but I feel like maybe they've been too abstract. It's difficult, like, you know, some people find it easy making themselves understood,
yeah.
You know, in their day-to-day life.
And yeah.
It's not something that I find easy. You're always trying to get better.
Yeah,
you know,
of
you're
course.
Always just trying to work on it. And, you know, we can't all be letting go of it straight away.
Yeah.
But, yeah. But, yeah, on this record, they're more direct, maybe.
Do you read the reviews? Did you read a lot of reviews when the record came out?
I have to say no, not this
okay.
time. I have done in the past, but to be honest, I just got bored of it because they all say the same thing. They're all like, you know, development, exploring, pushing the boundaries. And really, you know, we're just in a band. Like, I don't feel like we're pushing boundaries. We're just challenging ourselves. We're not like, you know, we're not reinventing music or something. We're just trying to be in a good band.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You know, and then that's kind of it.
I read somewhere that they felt that it was more personal, but also still not very transparent and difficult to reach. Is that something that you think you did deliberately while writing them?
I don't want to write in a mundane way. I don't want to write like, this morning I woke up and I went to the shops. You know, like, I don't know, some people like that, but yeah.
It works in some pop songs, I think.
But that's just not the way I see things. Yeah, absolutely, it does. But I think maybe the best pop songwriters write in a conversational way.
There was a song you wrote about an abusive relationship.
Yeah, there's a lot of country songs or girl group songs about a girl getting hit by the guy or whatever. And then I never really thought, you know, it's just not really, I don't know, I'm sure it's been covered, but yeah, I don't know. I felt like I couldn't really be any more personal than that.
Because how old are you now?
31.
31, yeah. Just turned 30, so it's a difficult time.
Is
I mean,
it?
It's an interesting, well, we're millennials, I think it's interesting. I think my friends tell me that they recognize it the way I am with my social media and the pace. And I mean, I think we're one of the last generations that's experienced a world without such access to social media and internet.
Weird to think
yeah.
of it as well. I wish I was better at it because, you know, if I was smart, I would have done it from the beginning. But,
yeah.
You know, it's not something that I feel is natural to me.
I think it was Josh Holm as well, urging everybody to just get off social media for long periods of time, and because he said it just undermined the creative process. Absolutely.
Yeah, and you know, it's like a quick dopamine reward as well.
So what can we expect from you in the future?
Do you want to know what to expect?
I want to know if there's things that you really want to do still that you haven't been able to do.
Yeah, but I mean, even just surviving would be fine.
Is it that uncertain for you?
No, but I think that's a challenge.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. No, you're right.
And that's something that I'd be happy if you did.
Huh.
Because you know, I think it's a really easy mistake for people to think that they can go off and do things on their own. You know, sometimes it's better if you don't have everything your own way.
Yeah. You know? Okay, that's an interesting perspective. Thank you so much for this.
That's all right.
Thank you. Great. Have a great show.